right. Giddy up. Come on, girls. Off we go.
Listen to him. Wonder they let you out of school.
Oh, they say it's good money.
And I say your mother wants to wash your mouth out with soap.
I don't know. Tuesday. You still do your posh people in Eden Square?
Tuesday. Oh, yes. Tuesdays and Thursdays. I'm going in on Saturday this week. They're going away. Gives me a chance to get at the floors.
It's all work, isn't it, eh? 10 hours a day, 5.5 days a week. I don't know why we don't drop dead the way we have to work.
Well, hard work keeps you young, that's what they say.
Keeps you out of mischief.
Next stop, Chelsea.
Got me foreigners this morning. Oh. They're around a lot, and no mistake.
Dirty, them foreigners.
Oh, plays pongs a garlic. And he's a funny little bloke, he is. Importer or something.
Import women, I should think. White slaves?
I don't know about that. But you never know what you're going to find in his bed when she's away.
Sex mad, that's what he is. Here, has he had a go at you yet?
Me? Not blooming likely. I'm bigger than he is to start with.
Bye-bye, Ada. Right, see you tonight. Here we go. Oh.
Dad.
Mrs. Harris, would you be a dear and bring me a cup of coffee, please?
Yes, m'lady. Thank you, Mrs. Harris. There are some letters at the end of my bed.
Oh, yes, m'lady.
Hello? Penny, darling.
Oh. The Lord Chamberlain is commanded by Her Majesty to invite Lord and Lady Dan to a coronation ball at Buckingham Palace.
I've never seen nothing so beautiful in my whole life. I'm going to wear one of them to the coronation ball at Buckingham Palace, but I can't decide which.
Oh, lovely. Lord, look at the workmanship on the front of that dress.
I got them from Dior in Paris. He really is the best in the world.
I'll bet they cost a pretty penny. Beg pardon, lady.
They were rather expensive. This one was 450 guineas, and the red one just a little bit less. Why don't you choose for me, Mrs. Harris?
Me?
Yes. Go on, you choose. Well, I mean, they're both beautiful. They're lovely, but, well, I think that the pale blue is best for the palace. They say Her Majesty likes pale colours.
Well, I think you're right. Thank you, Mrs. Arris.
Oh, sorry. Three light hours, please, Garfield. I know you're waiting.
I don't know why you bother with them football pools. Throwing away good money, if you ask me.
Well, it's only threepence. Last week, a bloke won more than 7,000 quid.
Aston Villa and Preston North End, no score draw. Oh, never a month of Sunday.
Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Come on, let's post this while my luck's running.
My friend here, she's won the pools. I've won.
Oh, go on, Paulie, Alpha.
But it's true. And here's the telegram to prove it. Oh, go on, Ada, open it.
Oh, no, Vi. Not here.
Oh, come on, Ada. Oh, come on, we're all funny. Oh, we'll have a nice little break, Ada.
Oh, Ada, for God's sake, open it up now. Wait, now, wait. Sit down. It's best that we both sit down.
Oh,
£174.06 and 4p.
Oh, them cheats! Them pools people are cheating sods.
I expect there was a lot got it right. It wasn't difficult last week.
God.
Well, it's a start anyway. Better than a slap in the face with a wet fish.
Start? Start of what?
For my Dior dress.
You what?
I'm going to get a Dior dress.
Who's he when he's home?
Just the most famous dress designer in the world, that's all. French. Lives in Paris.
Paris? Oh, you've got to go all the way to Paris just to get a dress?
Of course.
Oh, I wouldn't have nothing to do with them foreigners. Nah, if you want to buy a new dress, you go up Regent Street on Saturday. The sales are on.
I want a Dior dress.
Well, how much do they cost, then, these Dior dresses?
£450.
£450? Oh, go on, you're having me on. I think you're going to bar me. Where are you going to get that kind of money from? Folie de grandeur, that's what you got. Yeah, well, it's not for the likes of us, dear. It's not our place. Where are you going to wear it anyway?
Look, Vi, we may only be ordinary charwomen, but we can have our dreams, can't we? I mean, there's no law against that.
Dreams? That's about it.
Look, the dress I saw at Lady Dance is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my whole life, and I'm going to have one like it.
All that money. You'll have your husband turning in his grave.
I will not. He would approve, would my Reg. He had ambitions, and no wonder. He was a genius with begonias. People used to come from all over to see his flower clock. I'll tell you this, if my Reg was alive, he'd be the head gardener at Battersea Park right this very moment. An hour, 6 days a week, 6 hours a day, 52 weeks a year. That's...
Oh, come on, Ada, hurry up. Oh, we missed the cartoon.
I'm not coming with you tonight. I'm sorry, Vi.
But it's Grace Kelly and Gary Grant.
I've given up the flicks as part of my economy drive.
I don't believe it.
And I'm giving up smokes and gin and beer. Oh, and buses too.
All because of that blooming dress. Well, there'll be no fun left in life.
Well, I never cared much for gin anyway.
Oh, well, I've got to run.
I will miss my drop of beer, though. The master of the household.
as commanded by Her Majesty. No, that's not right. Has received Her Majesty's command to invite Mrs. Ada Arris to the ball.
Must have dropped off. Oh, no wonder. No one can work night and day. It stands to reason.
Yeah, but if I don't work hard, I won't have my dress in time for my funeral.
Sugar, give you energy.
Oh, it's a nice cup of tea, Vi. Thanks. It's a great laugh if you don't weaken. Oh, I was having ever such a lovely dream.
Like I said before, that's about all you've got left. Dreams.
I don't know why you're so nice to me, Vi. I don't really. You must think I'm bonkers. Clean round the bend.
Well?
I don't blame you. It doesn't make any sense. I know that. Slaving away just for a dream. The trouble is, I was born obstinate. And that's all there is to it.
Mrs. Harris?
Yes, that's me. What's wrong, then?
Nothing. The owners claim that diamond clip. Given you a reward.
A reward?
Yeah. Pity they're not all as honest as you, Grandma.
It never even entered my mind. Or only just.
£25, if you kindly sign the book, madam.
Oh, that's more like it, Constable. Thank you.
£25, I call that mingy. Them diamonds must have been worth thousands.
It's enough. It's all I need.
Oh, Lord. Why the new hats never sit straight? Handkerchief?
Her Britannic Majesty's Secretary of State.
My gloves. Have you seen my gloves?
No, dear. Requests and requires to allow the bearer to pass freely without let or hindrance. Fancy that.
But I put them out fresh this morning.
Do you know, Ada, I have never seen one of these before.
Well, you have now. Oh, why, you were sitting on them.
Oh, I'm ever so sorry, dear.
Oh, look, here's the taxi's arrived. Now, here's a spare key, just in case.
In case of what? You're only going away for the day.
Well, I mean, the house might go on fire. You never can tell.
Oh, Ada, why don't you change your mind and not go at all? Hey, just think of all the nice things you could have with that money.
No.
All those aeroplanes is always cracking. There was another disaster in the papers this morning.
Lightning never strikes twice.
They don't speak no English over there, you know. Ada!
They eat snails. It's taken me 3 long years of my life to get that money. And I'm not going to let a little thing like eating snails stop me now.
Where to, love?
Headquarters, British European Airways.
And quick, Ada, call it off before it's too late.
It's already too late, dear. I'm off.
Okay,
how do you do? Have a
nice day. Bloody funny.
I don't know.
Bonjour, madame. Qu'est-ce que vous désirez?
I've come to buy a dress at Dior. Is this the right place?
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez?
A dress. Me?
Oui, madame, oui, mais pas ici. De l'autre côté.
Madame Colbert,
I must warn you, La Comtesse de Lyon's account has not been paid.
She is a good client. She will pay.
Oh, not now. A lover is in prison for fraud.
Natasha.
Yes, madame.
You are late.
I'm sorry. There is a strike on the metro and the traffic is very bad.
Go on. Monsieur. My business is to sell dresses, not to inspect the bank accounts of our clients. That is your business. Now, please go. I have the collection to organize. I've reserved the banquet for the princess and her party.
Why have you put the Marquis de Chassin in the front row? That old fool never buys a thing.
He happens to be a good friend of Monsieur Dior, and he is a minister.
May I remind you, madame, that we are not running a charity. We are running a business.
And as chief founders, I will receive the Princess Margaret myself.
You will not? I am the director of the House of Dior. In the absence of the patron, I will escort Her Royal Highness to a seat.
Hello. Can you tell me the way to the dresses, please?
How did you get in?
I just walked in. Where are the dresses hung up, please?
Dresses? What dresses?
This is Dior's dress shop, isn't it?
Monsieur Dior's collection is shown in the afternoon by private invitation only.
Oh, well, then, if I were to come back this afternoon, would that be the best thing?
The salon is complete. It is filled for this afternoon and for the rest of the week.
You see, I've only got today. I took time off from my work. My name is Arris from London, and I've just come over to buy a dress. I've got the money right here.
Please, put it away.
Oh, it's genuine, all right.
I'm sure it is, Miss Harris.
Mrs. Harris.
Mrs. Harris, the salon is full today.
You see, the woman I work for had a Dior dress. I never seen nothing so beautiful in all my life. And I says to myself, I'm going to have one of those or die in the attempt.
I'm sad that you have wasted your time.
Haven't you ever wanted something so bad you could cry just thinking about it? Laying awake nights, dreaming of it? I've scrimped and saved and slaved for 3 years to earn this. And now you won't even let me see what I've come for. Some people have hard hearts, and no mistake.
Mrs. Harris, I have felt as you have felt. And anyway, good taste and cash are hard to find. Come back at 3 o'clock. The salon is full, but I will find a place for you on the stairs where you will be able to see the collection.
Oh, thank you, dear. That's really very kind. I'm in luck, aren't I?
Au revoir, Mrs. Harris.
Au revoir, madame.
Perhaps you will bring me some luck. And your presence will certainly annoy Monsieur Armand.
Vous avez une invitation, madame? Ah, entrez, s'il vous plaît. Bonjour, allez-y.
Ah, madame, parlez-moi.
Madam? Mrs. Arris.
Oh, yes. Find yourself a place on the stairs.
S'il vous plaît, votre Altesse, mademoiselle.
Oh, do you see who that is? That's our Princess Margaret.
Mrs. Harris, please come with me. I have a cancellation.
Oh, that's a bit of luck, isn't it? You're right, miss. Oh, what's this for, then?
So you may take the dress that you like.
Oh, thanks. Oh, look at those lovely flowers.
Yes, indeed. You like flowers, madame.
Oh, yes, I'm very fond of flowers. I see you've got a little rose in your buttonhole.
Yes, it's a rosette.
Oh. I've got some nice geraniums in my window box at home.
In England?
In London, yes. I've come over here to buy a dress.
I hope you find what you desire.
Are you going to buy a dress for someone?
Oh, no. I come here sometimes because I like beautiful clothes and beautiful women. It refreshes me. It makes me feel young again.
Now, that's nice. Oops. Sorry, dear. There we are.
Oh! Your saleswoman tried to place me next to that dreadful Englishwoman.
My apologies, Madame Croquette.
Well, do something about it.
Oh, one moment, madame.
Mrs. Harris is an important client.
She doesn't look important to me. Place her somewhere else immediately.
I shall not. There's no seats empty.
Well, put her on the stairs, in the gallery, anywhere.
This is the seat I assigned her.
I am the director of the House of Dior.
Then you move her. Then?
Madame, you can see the salon is full. I can promise you one seat in the front row for tomorrow.
I guess Belmain will have one seat for today.
Excuse me, madame. I am proud to think there is still some spirit of decency and honor left in this country.
Numéro 1, number 1, matinée, modeled by Dominique.
Charmant.
Numéro 15, number 15, Boulevard, modeled by Ariel. Numéro 22, number 22, Pigalle, modeled by Natasha. Numéro 73, number 73, Loisette.
Monsieur Marcel.
Numéro
35,
number 55.
Monsieur Marcel.
Modeled by Annette. Numéro 47, number 47, super, modeled by Suzanne.
Thanks very much.
Numéro 59, number 59, rêve du moulin, modeled by Joël. Number 68, Saint-Maurice.
Natacha, Natacha, allez, dépêche-toi, Natacha.
Number 89, Temptation. To finish the collection, Monsieur Dior offers Grand Mariage.
The collection always ends with a wedding dress. The girls who make it show a lock of hair into the scene for luck.
Dior.
Oh, you will not see him, madame. He's not here. He says the dresses are his children, and now they must make their own way in the world. Au revoir, madame.
Oh, goodbye. It was ever so nice knowing you. Oh, madame. Please.
Are you quite sure?
Oh, yes, number 89, Temptation.
437,000 francs.
Oh.
450 pounds.
Oh, thank heavens, that's just about exactly what I've got here.
Oh, not now. Come with me, and I'll arrange to have your dress brought.
I have a client for number 89. No comments. Just make the dress for her.
Enter, if you please.
Monsieur Marcel, Mademoiselle Claudine is a sister.
Enchanté, madame.
How do you do?
Please, sit down.
Oh, thanks.
Your dress.
Oh, it's beautiful. You make me wish I was young again. Poor thing, you must be tired, all that prancing around.
Oh, you're stronger than we look.
Oh, you don't have to tell me. I'm a working woman myself.
It is a pleasure to throw a dress to such a special client.
Special? Me?
Well, yes. In the show, you were so happy, so enthusiastic. I saw you often. Such appreciation is very inspiring. Thank you, madame.
Thank you, Natasha.
You know, I'm so happy you chose this dress. It is my favorite also.
Monsieur Favelle, our accountant. Our client wishes to pay for her dress in cash. Is that in order?
It is most unusual.
It's all in here. Let's take the lot.
I suppose it is possible.
Madame?
What's going on? This ain't a striptease, is it? Here, what's this all about? Here, give over, you naughty boy. You're tickling me.
We have to take your measurements, madame.
Oh, that's all right. I'm a size 12. Just wrap it up and I'll take it as it is.
But this is not your dress, madame.
Oh, I just pay for it.
Oh, no, no, this one. This is the only one there is.
This is a model. And we have another 2 weeks of shows. But we will make you one exactly the same to your measurements.
Make me one? How long will that take?
Normally, 3 weeks.
But I can't stay in Paris that long.
That means I can't have it.
Is there no way we can help this lady?
Hmm?
I will work on the dress every night.
And you will have a fitting every day. Madame, we will make the dress in 1 week.
You are kind, but a week? You see, I've got my work, my jobs, the people I do for. I have a friend, Mrs. Butterfield, but that would be imposing, wouldn't it?
I am sure if she is a real friend, she will not mind this, Mrs. Butterfield.
Yeah, but how can I tell her?
I would send her a telegram. And I will also book you a hotel.
A hotel? But I don't have any money. I've just got enough to get home.
Well, we will just have to find somebody for you to stay with. Unhappily, I only have one room.
And I live with my cousin.
Your receipt, madam. Everything's in order.
I might have to take it back.
Monsieur Fauvel, you told me your sister was away from Paris?
Yes. If you'll excuse me, I must get back.
Mrs. Harris has nowhere to stay in Paris.
Well, I'm not sure when my sister is.
But your sister is away and her room is empty, no? I am sure you have a kind heart, monsieur, and you would be doing all of us a great favor.
If madame would care, I invite her to stay in my home as a guest.
Do you really mean that?
Of course.
Oh, you are kind. You really are.
My address. I'm sorry I cannot take you. I only have a moped.
I have my car. I can drive you.
So, you will have your dress after all.
Yes.
Madame Colbert, I want to see you immediately. I don't want to see that woman in our salon ever again.
But she has ordered...
I don't care if she has ordered the old collection. That English woman must never have at your dress.
They're all the same, the nice ones. Don't you ever trust a tidy man.
Mrs. Harris?
Yes.
Well, my sister's room's in there. Oh, mademoiselle, I cannot permit you to enter this pigsty.
Oh, what's all the fuss about? Where's the broom cupboard?
This way.
Oh, yeah.
If monsieur does not mind, I would like to stay now.
Oh, no. That is impossible. You, of all people, Mademoiselle Natasha.
Can't you see? She wants to help.
I have some things to buy anyway.
Well, run along then. Here you go. Oh. Well, I never thought I'd see a Dior model waxing the floor. How about a nice cup of cha?
Cha?
Tea.
Yes.
Oh. This foreign tea looks too weak to crawl up the spout. Oh, it must be so thrilling wearing all those lovely clothes in front of people like Princess Margaret.
Oh, scrubbing the floor is a much more honest job than making a lot of money prancing about in expensive dresses like a moving clothes peg.
Horse, clothes, horse.
yes, clothes, horse.
I bet you've got plenty of men asking you out.
Yes, but for those sort of rich men, I am only a toy, a decoration. They think it is so smart to have a model from one of the top fashion houses sitting beside them. It gives them a cachet, a show-off, like a new Ferrari or a big cigar.
Oh.
I come from a small farm near Lyon. For me, I would be so happy in a place of my own like this, with my children, ready to greet my husband when he comes back from work. Have you any children?
No, Natasha. I wish I had, but I haven't.
But you are married.
Widowed. He looked after the gardens in the park where we lived. He had green fingers, my husband, Reg. Everything grew for him.
I'm so sorry.
We was very happy. A short life, but a sweet one. That's what they say. Have you got a boyfriend?
Yes.
Do you love him?
I suppose so.
You know, you could push off now. Thanks for your help.
Oh, no. I must finish my flower.
Mademoiselle, I can never thank you enough.
Oh, don't thank me. Thank Mrs. Arris.
After such labors, you must be hungry. Would you do me the honor? Could I hope that you will stay for dinner?
Oh, no, I'm sorry, I cannot. I have to go to a party and I'm late already. Ah, au revoir, Mrs. Arris.
Goodbye, dear.
Until tomorrow?
Yes.
Well, thank you for cleaning the house.
Well, someone had to do it, didn't they? Sometimes I think that was why I was put on this earth.
Well, at least I have you for dinner.
Oh, you don't have to feed me.
Oh, you're my guest.
Oh, thanks.
Voila. Crêpe Suzette.
Oh, you ain't half a cook, André. Your wife's gonna be a lucky girl.
If I ever find one.
You fancy Natasha, don't you?
You've guessed my secret.
Not much of a secret. Every time she's around, you look like the cat what's seen the cream.
But today, she spoke to me for the first time.
Why don't you ask her out sometime?
I think not. I'm only an accountant. I expect she's already forgotten my name. Natasha has the whole world to choose from.
Well, what makes you think she's so different to any other girl when there's a nice-looking boy about?
Me? No.
Faint heart never won, fair lady.
No, madame. It is not possible. Not even a magician could arrange this.
I've never seen no one as quick with pins as you are.
Well, I get a lot of practice.
Hello, Natasha. They're trussing me up like a chicken.
Now, you know what I must endure at least 20 times a day.
Oh, an old hair petticoat. Last time I seen one of these was on my grandmother.
It is necessary to sustain the skirt. There is over 40 yards of fabric in it.
Crikey, that's enough to make a pair of curtains for the Queen.
Will you permit me to show you something of Paris this evening?
Oh, I like that. But none of your posh places, mind.
Oh, no, no. I promise you. Le vrai Paris, hein? The real Paris.
Might I bring my friend along with me, please?
Oh, but of course. Until 6 o'clock.
All right.
Mademoiselle, you have the body of a young woman.
Oh, don't give me none of that. Flattery will get you nowhere. Betty says that to all the girls.
No, most of them are fat old trouts.
Monsieur Armand, Madame Coquette is here.
Good morning, madame. What is your pleasure?
My pleasure is none of your business. I'm giving Dior a second chance. I'll take some of your dresses.
So gracious, madame.
And your friend?
Oh, he's just coming.
Monsieur Fauvel.
Is that all right?
But of course.
Hey, glass, hey, glass.
Please wait. I will buy the tickets.
No, you are my guest.
It is my pleasure.
Nice boy, Andre.
Yes.
Brave too. Wounded during the war, he told me.
Oh. I'm sure he's kind and decent, but he's dull and boring. He never opens his mouth.
He's shy, that's all.
He's like all accountants. He's only interested in figures.
Mm. I'm sorry. We've just missed a boat. Oh. There's no boat for 1 hour.
Oh, well, not to worry. Now, there's something that I'd like you both to show me.
I think I will stay here. I do not like heights.
Oh.
Mrs. Arris, will you excuse me if I return to my house?
Well, what's up with you then? Aren't you feeling well?
She doesn't want me, it's obvious. I'm spoiling your evening.
Oh, nonsense. You don't even know each other yet. Well, I don't care much for heights myself. I can't leave her sitting there in the car. Come on. Faint heart never won fair lady. Why don't we all go and have a nice bit of refreshment? Oh, isn't this lovely? Let's have a nice glass of beer. Cheers. Oh, that's lovely and cool. Nothing like a beer. Just like home. If it's a fine evening, my friend Mrs. Butterfield and I often go down to the local pub, sit outside and have a beer. Oh, that's jolly.
Madame, I have not danced for some time, but if you would give me the pleasure.
Oh, heavens, my dancing days are over.
When was that?
Is that a scar on your cheek?
It was only a scratch, really, in the battle for Tunis.
Were you an officer?
No, just a legionnaire in Algiers.
That's very well.
Who couldn't hit you, mademoiselle?
I am very thirsty.
That's more like it. I was in a panic when I first arrived, but I'm really beginning to enjoy myself. Cheers.
Neighbor from London. How do you like this market?
Well, I wouldn't have believed it if I hadn't seen it with my own two eyes.
Have you a garden at home?
Well, hardly a garden, just the geraniums I spoke of. Oh, and sometimes the people I do for give me their leftovers, if you know what I mean. I just cut off the stems
and put a copper in the water, they come back as fresh as you like.
A copper?
Ah.
Well, one is never too old to learn.
Here. I'll give you these. They might come in useful sometime.
I'm sure they will, Mrs. Mops.
Who's Mrs. Mops?
Oh, forgive me. I hardly knew I said it. I'm getting old. You see, when I was young, my father sent me to school in England. The other boys were not kind to me because I was not...
Because you was foreign. Oh, I know the sort. Little devils.
Even the grown-ups were a little stuffed shirt. Only the lady who cleaned my room was kind to me. I have never forgotten it. She had a heart of gold, that woman. I called her Mrs. Mops.
Ah.
I'm sure you have a heart of gold.
Well, I don't know about that, but I do my best.
Let us sit down for a moment and enjoy the sun. Did you buy a dress from Monsieur Dior?
Oh, yes. That's why I'm still here. All them fittings you need.
Oh, I know. If my wife wasn't having her hair done, she was being fitted for a new dress. Which one was it now? Temptation?
Yeah, you've got a good memory, I must say.
I remember the mannequin as much as the dress.
She
is one of the most beautiful girls in Paris. If I was a little younger...
That's Natasha. You know, she's become a real friend of mine. Well, they all have, really. Andre, he's the accountant. He's given me a bed. Well, they've all been so kind. You wouldn't believe it.
I'm glad to hear it.
Since we was in school, isn't it? Did you ever play hopscotch when you was little?
I do not remember.
Well, come on, let's have a go. Yeah, you beat me. You're good, you are.
And you are a good tonic, Mrs. Mops. Allow me to introduce myself.
Le Marquis.
Marquis.
Marquis, yeah. Hippolyte.
It is a strange name, I grant you, but my friends call me Hippo. I hope you will do the same.
Hippo. Minister. Ministry? You in the government?
I have to confess it.
Well, I'll never.
I am the minister without portfolio, which means I must do everybody's dirty work. If I arrange it, will you take luncheon with me tomorrow?
Oh, I should like that very much.
Yeah. Au revoir, Mrs. Mops.
Thank you for a happy evening.
I enjoyed myself. They are beautiful. Thank you. Would you like to go for a walk?
Oh, yes. I would.
S'il vous plaît. I dreamed of being in Paris, and walking along the Seine.
I'm sure everyone says it, but I would like to say it too. You're very beautiful.
goodness. I must go. I'm so sorry.
You've kept me waiting.
I did not notice the time.
Why are you always late for everything? Who's that you're with?
Oh, not anybody. Just a man from the accounts department. He was talking to me about my taxes.
A clerk. A Ben Busher. I hope this is not another one of your lies.
Ah, mademoiselle, today is our jour de fête, the day of liberation.
Is something wrong?
No. No, it is a personal matter. You must forgive me. For Marcel, today is a day of celebration, but for me, it is one of great sadness. My husband was killed in the war.
I know how you feel. I buried one myself, you poor thing.
12 years ago, Michel was shot. He was in the resistance. He was betrayed.
Are you sure he was betrayed?
I was there. I was his wireless operator. I managed to escape.
Oh, your husband was a real hero. You must be proud of him.
I am. I am very proud of him. But he has been forgotten by his country. There is no memorial, no medal, no letter even from the government. Every year I write. Nothing.
General de Gaulle himself was a hero. I mean, if he knew.
You do not know France, madame. They do not care to remember the war. All they care about is money.
Oh, merci, madame.
Ah, Madame Croquette, quel honneur!
I'm here for my fitting.
Of course, come with me, madame. What time is your appointment, madame?
About now, I should think.
And your fitter is madame...
Madame is right.
Ah, Monsieur Marcel, of course.
But he knows the way I like things done.
Madame Croquette has arrived for her fitting.
Madame is a little early. Perhaps you would care to wait here.
If I want to wait, I go to the dentist.
No, immediately. This room is free.
Moment, madame. I will get your dress.
My God, it's a ghastly woman from England. Dior isn't selling a dress to her, is he?
It is a mistake. This way, madame.
Please enter here, madame.
Allez.
Vite. Why is that woman still here when I forbade it?
She has ordered a dress, and it's my business to see that she gets it.
Can't you see that allowing such a woman to have one of our dresses is an insult to the house of Dior? Our image is tarnished. It is also an insult to our clients. Madame Croquette will spread a scandal all over America, and she is important, very important.
The only important thing about Madame Croquette is that her husband owns oil wells.
She is rich. We cannot exist without the patronage of the rich.
Mrs. Arris has paid in cash.
Probably stolen, like you would buy a second-hand car.
Oh, my.
Cancel the transaction immediately. Send her away. Those are my orders.
Well.
Weird. Look, I best go, Edna. Look, I don't want to get you lot in trouble.
You bought a dress. You shall have it.
Of course, madame must have her dress.
But, I mean, I'm not an important client like she is.
Oh, but you are much more important to us than that woman, isn't she, madame?
Most certainly. Don't worry, we'll find a way. I know. We'll give you a new name.
A sort of code name?
Exactly.
What about Mrs. Mops?
Mrs. Mops?
Mrs. Mops.
Very chic. From now on, Claudine, this dress is for Mrs. Mops.
Yes, madame. André, I did not mean to hurt you by what I said.
No need. You spoke the truth. Just a man from the accounts department. That's all I am. Foolish to have fallen in love with you. To have invented stupid messages so that I could just get a glimpse of you in the salon. Forget you ever met me.
André, you are not a foolish person. You are kind and caring and sweet.
Natasha! So, I catch you again with your clerk. Your pen pusher!
I can explain.
Shut up, you dirty common little slut!
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Finito, we're finished.
My poor André. Are you all right? Did he hurt you?
I'm very sorry for you.
Be happy for me. It is possible that I am starting to like you. That's all.
Bravo, Monsieur André. Comme ça.
Thanks. Bit better than the old 19 bus.
Monsieur the Minister is engaged on the telephone, madame. He will attend to you in a few moments.
I've seen that girl somewhere before.
Mrs. Mops, how nice to see you. I took your advice.
Will you look at that?
A glass of champagne before we eat. An aperitif. It is good for the appetite.
Oh, don't mind if I do. Cheers.
Santé.
Oh, don't have to tickle your nose. It's nice, though.
A little more, perhaps.
Oh, no thanks. You'll have me tiddly before we start.
Let us have some luncheon then.
Yes.
Come. Please.
Oh, you could have the whole government to dinner if you wanted to.
Sometimes I used to when my wife was alive. But now, I usually eat alone.
I know the feeling. How long's it been for you?
2 years, a little more.
It's been 20 for me. They say the first year's the hardest, but they're all hard if you ask me. Such a lovely place you got here. Pity you haven't got anyone to share it with. No family?
I have a daughter, but she is married.
Oh, that girl in the picture outside. I knew it. She was outside the kiddie school in the flower market with a little girl.
That was my granddaughter, Claire. That is why I go every day to the flower market, to watch Claire go to school. Unhappily, my daughter and I, we don't speak to each other.
Oh, why did they not?
Louise married against my wishes.
Oh, probably fell in love with a bloke, eh?
Possibly. The bloke is a loud-mouthed, unpleasant fellow. He is a professor of some sort or another, and a socialist.
My dear wife used to act as a sort of buffer between us. But now...
Well, surely let bygones be bygones with little Claire growing up.
Unfortunately, we have a rather proud family. We do not forgive easily. And my daughter is the same.
Chip off the old block, eh? Well, forgive and forget, that's my advice. It may not taste nice, but pride can be swallowed.
You never had problems with your children?
I never had none. More's the pity.
I'm sorry.
My husband, Reg, he was gassed in the Great War. He was a real hero, my Reg. He crawled out into no man's land to rescue a mate, and he got stuck in a shell hole. And his lungs were never the same again. He was in and out of hospital. I never could afford to take the time to have a baby. We kept putting it off. And that's what I really regret. You don't know how lucky you are. A child is the most important thing in the world.
It is not a subject I wish to discuss anymore. How is the great dress coming on?
Oh, it's going to look lovely. I hope.
You only hope?
Well, we've had a bit of a tussle with Monsieur Armand. He can't stick my guts, that man. He looks at me like I was something that the cats brought in. Thinks I'll give the place a bad name.
What nonsense. He's a stupid, pompous man. I'm sure that you and Madame Colbert will be a match for him.
Oh, she's a real star, that poor Madame Colbert.
What is so poor about Madame Colbert?
Oh, her husband was shot. He was betrayed in the resistance.
Alas, so many brave people were.
Oh, but he was forgotten.
Forgotten?
By the government. I mean, not a word. Not a dicky bird, not a medal, not a letter, not anything in all the time that she's written.
What was his name?
Michel.
Michel?
Michel Colbert. Funny, isn't it, really? Us all been in the same boat, you, me and Madame Colbert. All lost a loved one. Well, no complaining, is it? When I'm in the dumps, I think of my husband, Reg, and I know what he'd say. No good looking back. Life's for the living. Keep your pecker up. Keep smiling.
I am so glad that you came today, Mrs. Mops. It is not often that I have the chance to talk.
Quick, you must go. Monsieur Armand is coming.
Oh, my coat.
Monsieur Armand, would you care to check the placement for the show?
No, thank you, madame. I am sure your arrangements are quite correct.
One of the outside buyers.
Dépêchez-vous, on traverse. Venez ici, Nadine, Claudine, dépêchez-vous. Allô, attention les voitures, s'il vous plaît. Ne courez pas.
Excuse me, madam.
What do you want?
I know your father, the Marquis.
I have no money to give you.
Oh, and I don't want none. I've not come here begging for myself. I just want to put a word in for your dad.
I do not see my father. We don't speak.
I know how it is. But he loves you and Claire, and he misses you very much.
All he has to do is to pick up the telephone.
Did you know that every morning he sits on that bench over there, hoping to catch a glimpse of you and your daughter? He's old and obstinate and proud.
Oh, I know all that.
And lonely. You have no idea how lonely he is in that great big house without you.
Allô, maman?
Give him a chance, madam.
Madame Corbert, who is Mrs. Mops, who has ordered model number 89?
Mrs. Mops is Dutch. Her husband makes vacuum cleaners. She is very rich.
Ah, thank you, madame.
Oh, Mrs. Harris. I have had the most marvelous news.
I have had a letter about my husband.
From the government.
From the general. Michel is to be awarded the Croix de Guerre with Palm. And his name is to be inscribed in the Book of Heroes of the Resistance. And I am to be given the Medaille de la Resistance from the general himself.
Well, isn't that lovely news? Congratulations.
Thank you.
How about a cup of tea?
Oh, no, thank you.
Blame you, it tastes like dishwater. I mean, look at this. You French have got some very strange habits. I was just writing a postcard to my friend Mrs. Butterfield. Can't wait to tell her that I had lunch with the Marquis. The Marquis. Oh, I forgot his name.
De Chassin.
That's it. How do you spell it?
Oh, it doesn't matter. Because your dress will be ready later today, and you'll be able to go home after the final fitting.
Today? Well, thanks for coming to tell me.
No, thank you. It is you who brought me this luck. I know it is.
Of course not. What nonsense. It's mine. It's the most beautiful dress in the world. And it's mine. Thank you.
And now you can try it on.
Mrs. Mops, indeed. You have disobeyed my instructions. You have lied and deceived me, all of you.
Oh, but they was only doing what was right.
Your order is cancelled.
But that's my dress.
Take it back to the workroom. It must be destroyed. Immediately.
The order is not cancelled.
Take the dress away.
You're a thief, you are. I paid for that dress.
And it belongs to her.
No longer. You will be paid back, madame. Now go.
I am in charge of the sales in the House of Dior.
Not anymore, madame. You are dismissed.
But you can't...
Clear out your desk and go. And as for you, madame, out!
worked and slaved all these years for that dress, and I'm not having it taken away from me now. You can't set Mother Colbert. She's done nothing wrong. It's not fair.
Go, or I will send for the police.
Is expecting you,
Bonjour, monsieur.
Ah, monsieur le ministre, good morning. What a pleasure it is to see you again. How can I help you?
I have come to see the patron.
Oh, I'm afraid that is not possible. The patron has given strict orders that he is not to be disturbed when he is deciding.
I have a serious complaint. It has come to my ears that an English lady has been insulted by an employee of this house.
If you do me the honor of coming to my office, I will deal with the matter immediately.
I have spoken to Monsieur Dior on the telephone. He is expecting me.
My dear Ippo.
My dear Christian.
Please come in.
Madame Colbert? Oh, what are you doing here? I'll never be able to forgive myself. I've gone and got you sacked. And I thought everything was going quite well.
On the contrary, I have been appointed director of the House of Dior. And Monsieur Armand is to be confined to the office as administrator.
I can't believe it.
We told the Marquis de Chassagne what had happened, and he went to see Monsieur Dior, who was, of course, very angry with Armand. And...
Monsieur Dior arranged it himself.
Well, I never did. My dress. Look.
We would like you to be godmother to our first child.
Oh, God bless you both. Now I can go home happy. Oh, crikey. I'm going to miss my plane if I'm not careful.
Well, let us check everything first.
Yes.
Passport.
Yep.
Air ticket.
Yep.
Have you enough money?
Well, I've got £9. That'll get me home.
And the money for the customs?
What money for what customs?
Well, the customs in London will demand 6 shillings in the pound on a dress. That is £135.
Yeah, nobody told me about that.
Don't be ridiculous, André. None of our clients ever pay any duty. We just smuggle the clothing through the customs.
That would be a lie, wouldn't it? I couldn't do that. I mean, I don't mind a fib or two, but I couldn't tell a lie. That'd be breaking the law, wouldn't it? I mean, I could go to jail.
Yeah, the British customs are very severe.
Oh, Lord, let me go home and die.
What about the valise?
Mrs. Harris, come with me. I think Natasha has found a solution to our problem.
My dear friend.
Ippo, I've got my lovely dress, thanks to you. Oh, I don't know how to thank you.
I don't really.
You have given me back my daughter and my grandchild. The happiness that you have brought me can never be repaid. Dear Mrs. Mopes. I have come to take you to your aeroplane.
How very kind. I'll be with you in two shakes of a duck's whisker.
Passport. Been to Gay Paris, eh? Bit of ooh-la-la, Folie Bergère?
Oh, nothing vulgar like that. A few parties with my acquaintances. I saw all the sights. Oh, and I had a meal with my friend, the Marquis de Chassagne.
Are you sure it wasn't Napoleon?
Oh, a distant relative, I believe.
Yes. Well, we haven't got all day. Anything to declare?
Oh. Only me Dior dress.
Yeah. Well. Next, please.
Toast to Mrs. Arris, who brought us all such luck and such happiness.
To Mrs. Arris.
To Mrs. Arris.
To Mrs. Arris.
Kind of help me out. You saved my bacon and no mistake.
Oh, it weren't no trouble. I had a few hours to spare.
Well, a friend in need is a friend indeed. I brought this back for you.
Oh, thank you, Ada.
I shall treasure this always.
Well, did you get the dress?
Yes.
You paid all that money for that? Well, I must say, you'll never have a chance to wear it. Never in a month of Sundays.
I have worn it.
When?
At a party some friends gave for me in Paris.
Go on, pull the other one. I'll put the kettle on, make us a nice cup of tea.